Hello there, my name is Sahil. Welcome to Weights and Caffeine. In this video, I'm going to speak to you about caffeine. Is it a drug or a micronutrient? Coffee is the world's most consumed beverage and is the main source of caffeine for almost every individual. Yet the topic of caffeine consumption is very controversial. Now let's speak about caffeine without being biased. Okay, so firstly, let me just tell you whether it is good to consume caffeine or not. And the answer to that is yes. Caffeine is great for your health, and now I'm going to tell you why it is considered to be a drug. Okay, so it is believed that caffeine is an addictive substance. It is believed that it increases epinephrine. It is believed that it messes up with the dopamine system. But caffeine only increases epinephrine and cortisol in the absence of carbohydrates. It does not mess up with the dopamine system. It actually increases dopamine. And calling caffeine an addictive substance based on the research which show everyday consumption of caffeine is so stupid. A compound is addictive when you cannot stop the consumption once you have started, and the consumption keep on increasing. But with caffeine, it's not like that. So for example, there are days when I consume about 9 cups of coffee, and there are days when I don't consume caffeine at all, and I don't feel like the need to consume caffeine. Now I will tell you the benefits of caffeine. Consumption of caffeine is directly related to low incidence of hypothyroidism. Caffeine helps in increasing the conversion of T4, the inactive thyroid, to T3, the active thyroid, by detoxifying the liver, as most of the conversion happens inside the liver. Caffeine increases progesterone, testosterone, and the conversion of testosterone to DHT, which result in a decrease in estrogen, as DHT cannot be converted into estrogen unlike testosterone. And caffeine also detoxifies the liver from estrogen. Caffeine protects against the Alzheimer's, caffeine protects against the carcinogenesis, and high amounts of caffeine can help in reduction of cancer. Caffeine protects the heart muscles against calcification. Consumption of caffeine is inversely related to calcification of soft tissues. Caffeine consumption is inversely related to suicide and serotonin production inside the brain. Caffeine prevents the accumulation of free fatty acids in the blood and prevents toxicity from heavy metals, endocrine disruptors, and radiation. Caffeine helps in fat loss by increasing the metabolism, so your body burns more calories at rest. And that is the reason why most pre-workouts and fat burners in the market use caffeine as a main ingredient. I think I've made my point that caffeine is great. Now you must be wondering, how much should I take? Usually I recommend 3 cups a day, but if you like it, you can have 5 cups a day. And if you don't like it but you still want the benefits, you can have 2 cups a day. Now I am going to tell you the real side effects that come with caffeine. First, it is acidic in nature. But you don't have to worry about it, so is tomatoes, onions, and a lot of fruits. Second, it is going to increase epinephrine and cortisol if you don't have carbs with it. So if you like your coffee black, then do have some carbs with it. But if you like it with milk and sugar, then you don't have to worry about it. Caffeine is not a drug. It should be considered a very vital micronutrient, as it is very protective. Well, that is it for this video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel and our newsletter. Do check out weightsandcaffeine.com, and I am going to see you in the next video.